Now, inhale, fold the Om. Take a deep, long breath. Fold the Om. Feel the vibration. Shanti, shanti,
shanti,
shanti.
shanti.
Bring your both palms, love your palms. Please open your eyes. Very slowly while blinking, looking at your palm gently. Open up your eyes with a great smile. So, in previous session, we discussed about the Ayurveda, the meaning of the Ayurveda, the purpose of the human being, definition of health. We discuss these things. Today we're going to understand that what Ayurveda is talking about, the disease, the sickness, illness, and how these diseases are formed, and what is the cause of the physical and mental suffering. So,
ma'am, your voice is cracking. Okay, cool. It's not just me.
Guys, now you can hear me better?
Yes.
So, basically, we talked how the cause of physical mental suffering of because of imbalance of the three dosha. So, three dosha. TREDOSHA. Three dosha. So Ayurveda believe in these things that if somebody is having any kind of imbalance, they would be having the sickness, disease, mental and psychosomatic disease even, they are having it because of the imbalance between the three dosha. What is the three dosha? There is no English translation is available. So I'll try to explain it. Three dosha, which composing everything around you, which is outside. It's a quality. The way you look like, the ways your eyes, your eyebrows, your hair texture, your skin color, your personality, the way you behave, everything is decided by the tridosha, the combination of the tridosha. And same, these things are governing outside also. It is in the day, it is in the night, it is in the climate, it is in the season. So these, everything, whatever you're saying it, is because of the tridosha. And these three dosha is made of the combination of the panchmahabhut. Panchmahabhut, you know, panchmahabhut, P-A-N-C-H, panch, maha, M-A-H-A, ma, bhut. B, B for Bombay, H, double O, T, bhut, panch mahabhut. So panch mahabhut is composing dosha. What is a panch mahabhut? Five gross element, the fire, which is represented by the tha. So this is fire element in your finger. Then this is the air element, fire, air, which we call Agni, Vayu. Then we have Akash, space. Then the Prithvi, the earth. And then Jal is water. This is the Panch Mahabhut, five gross element, which composing the Tridosha. And as you know, the whole cosmos is made of the five gross element. Okay, so five gross element has certain qualities, certain attributes. So combination of the Panch Mahabhut making the Tridosha. And how the Panch Mahabhut is composed? Because of the Triguna. Triguna, T-R-I-G-U-N-A, Triguna. So Triguna composing the Panch Mahabhut. So you have to see the link. Triguna is what? Quality of the matter. In Sankhya philosophy and many philosophy, it said that the matter has the quality, certain quality. The matter has the three main quality, that is a sattvic, rajasic and tamasic. Sattva, raj and tam, three quality. We're going to talk about more in detail, don't worry about it. Even in philosophy class you would be having, but I'm just giving the brief connection. This whole cosmos is made of the matter. Even metaphysics is proving this. Physics talks about the matter and the energy concept. This whole cosmos is made of the matter and matter having this certain energy. But energy is called consciousness and matter has its attributes, its quality, its own quality. That called sattva, raj and tam. Sattva quality, sattva means harmony in the matter, in the surrounding, when everything is calm, peaceful. That is the quality of you even and the matter. Sometimes you are relaxed, no? Sometimes you are calm. You're not angry. You're not laughing loud. You're not even sad. Sometimes you're just relaxed, calm. That is the quality of the sattva. Then movement. Movement within you and movement in the surrounding. That is because of the rajaguna. Guna is G-U-N-A, guna. Guna is the quality you can take. Sattu give you the harmonious, give you harmony, calmness, relaxation. Raj make you move, give you mobility. Any kind of movement which is happening to you and in the environment is happened because of the rajaguna. The quality of the movement, quality of the matter of moving, that is because of rajaguna. Then we have tam, tamoguna, T-A-M-A. Tam, sattu, S-A-T-T-V-A, sattu, raj, R-A-J. I'll give you the chart, don't worry about it. Raj, R-A-J, raj. Then tam, T-A-M-A, tam. tamo guna basically stillness, bringing the stillness in the environment and within you. You are able to sit because of tamo guna. You're able to sleep because of tamo guna. You're able to, you know, something is moving and there's a pause. There's a stop. It's because of tamo guna. Even in the environment. So these are the three qualities of the matter. Matter, the three quality, sattva, raj, tam, which composing the panch mahabhut gross element. Okay. And then these gross element making the tridosha. So when we're going to talk about the tridosha, you understand it's quite related, same attributes having, which is triguna is having it. You see the similarity because they are indirectly composed by the triguna. So I'll show you the chart which give you the understanding. Can you see this chart? Is visible to you?
Yes.
So this chart, you can see the sattva, raj and tam is making the panch mahabhut, and panch mahabhut is water, fire, space and air. And how this water, fire, space and raj is making, I've written down the percentage also. The elemental composition, which we're going to discuss later on. Don't worry about it when we're doing the Mitahar. So sattva rajatam, triguna, making man panch mahabhut, that is water, fire, space, and air. Okay. And the quality of the water, the guna which is present in the water, that is tifo tam plus sattva. So water has the quality of stillness also and harmonious also. So tam and sattugun making the water. It is the quality of the water. Okay. Then fire is made of the sattu plus rajagun. Sattu plus rajagun. This is the quality of the fire, which we called agni. Then space, akash, that is made of the sattva. Then air is made of the raj only. The quality of the air is raj. Then earth, the quality of the earth is tam, the prithvi tattva. Write it down this. Down till here. You understood till here?
Ma'am, I can't see the percentage.
Okay, percentage. If any doubt regarding to this chart, which you don't understand, I'll explain this chart. The percentage we're gonna take later on. But this much you understood how what is making what.
Yes, ma'am. So these Triguna comprises of Panchmahabhut, and Panchmahabhut are three. Panchmahabhut are five.
Exactly. Panch means five. Mahabhut means gross element. Like, write it down the literal meaning also. Panch means five, and Mahabhut, Maha means gross, Bhut means element. Five gross element, which is composing the whole Brahman, the cosmos. And the quality of this Panch Mahabhut is coming from the Triguna, Sattva, Raj, and Tam. This is the base of the matter. It is the quality of the matter. Okay, which is metaphysical.
The three Triguna, that is Sattva, Rajas, and Tamas, three Triguna makes up Panch Mahabhut. And Panch Mahabhut have five gross elements. Okay.
Exactly. And I've write it down which Triguna is making what Panch Mahabhut. Okay. Done. Shall we move further?
Yes.
Okay. Now come to the three dosha. So write it down the three dosha. T-R-I-D-O-S-H-A. Three dosha. Now, three dosha is composed by the element of the Panch Mahabhut. Okay. So Panch Mahabhut is making the three dosha. Three dosha is what? I told you what the way you look like, okay? The way you behave, your persona, your personality, everything is because of the three dosha. The way you think, that is also because of the three dosha. Okay. So three dosha, Vat, Pit, and Kapha. Vat, Pit, and Kapha. Okay. Vat, V-A-T, a Vat, Pit. I'll write it down for you. So three dosha. First is Vat, which is made of Vayu plus Akash. Vayu plus Akash. I'll give you the English meaning also. Don't worry about it. Then Pit which is made of Agni plus water, is Jala or water or Appa. Then Kapha. Guys, anytime which you don't understand, just ask the question, okay? Don't hesitate to raise your questions. Kapha is made of Prithvi, Tattu, plus Jala. I I'll explain you. Just write it down. Done. Guys, have you noted down?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So these three dosha, vat, the pronunciation vat, pitt, kapha. Okay, kapha. So vat, pitt, and kapha. Vat is composed by the vayu. Vayu means air. Air. A-I-R. A-I-R, air, okay? Air element. Plus composition with what? Space, akash, which we call space and akash. This is composing the vat element, okay? So vat function is what? Vat function in your body give you the movement, all kind of movement. That is the same quality of the raj even, okay? So vat also having the raj quality. So movement, whatever movement you are having in your body, that is because of the vat. You're moving your eyes, you're moving your lips, you are intaking anything, that even the hand movement, you know, yawning, blinking, everything, tiny to the big movement, it's because of the vat. There's a types of the vat, but which we're not gonna understand. Which we're not going to cover it, right? The majorly, the vat function is what? Give you the movement. Okay? So when vat go imbalance, you have the difficulty in the movement. Clear? When you vat go imbalance, then you have the difficulty in the movement. The location of the vat in your body, though your vat is prevalent from top to the till the bottom, like tip of the toe, everywhere is vat. But there's a major location of the vat in your body. So major location of the vat in your body, that is below the navel region. From navel to the tip of the toe is the vat location. So though we have everywhere the vat, but Ayurveda talks about it, there's a major location of the vat, which is below the navel, from the navel to the tip of the toe. That is a major location of the vat. And function give you the major function of the vat is what? Give you the movement. And when it's going imbalance, you have the difficulty in the movement. Now come to the pit. There is a types of the pit also. So pit is what? Made of the agni and the little water. Pit, agni and the little water. Agni is what? Fire. And jal called water. So by composition, we have the pit. Pitta function in your body is basically digestion, assimilation, absorption, your metabolic rate, maintaining the heat of your body. So this is the major function of your pit in the body. Pitt is again prevalent in entire body, but major location of the pit is above the navel towards the chest. Above the navel towards the chest, the major location of the pit. If pit go imbalance, you have the problems in your like you feel more heat, right? Or you feel more cold with going imbalance, then you have problem of digestion, assimilation. You cannot absorb the food. So these are the, you get more angry. These are the major issue when pitta go imbalance. So this is the pit. Now kapha. Kapha is made of the prithvi tattva and the water. Prithvi is earth and the jal, the water. This composition gives you the solidity in your body. Kapha is everywhere in your body. So solidity. You can see this part is very solid, right? The muscles is solid, bones are solid, is because of the kapha. The structure which is giving to you is because of the kapha. So kapha gives you solidity and lubrication in your body. All the parts of your body is because of the kapha. So lubrication and the solidity is given by the kapha and the growth and the development. To the body is because of the kapha. So kapha location, though I told you entire body, but major location of the kapha, kapha is throat to the head, this area. From throat to the top of the head, this area kapha is located. So whenever you get cold, cough, mucus is coming a lot. Mucus mostly is generated from these areas, right? Most of the time. So because this is the major location on the cup. Then cardiovascular disease and absorption, digestion thing is majorly located in chest and the navel area. And once you get the imbalance of the pit, so these areas are affected. Then vat is basically helping you to remove your waste, you know, it's working on taking out the waste from the body, then give you the movements like bone related issues. People cannot walk. First, their joints are affected. Knee joints are mostly affected because major location is vat here. They have difficulty in walking. So even periods irregular, if some kind of problems you have related to the lower part of your body, it means because of the vat would be playing the role in that. So this is the general idea about vat, pit and kapha. Okay, and location is clear, their function. The major function is clear and their the composition, okay, is clear. Till any doubt here, shall we move?
I just want to cross check that vat gives movement. Function of vat is that it gives movement. Okay.
Major function of the vat is give you the mobility. Okay. Now, Ayurveda talks about the disease form because of imbalance of in these three doshas. The two words vikrit and avikrit come. Vikrit and avikrit. V-I-K-A-R-I-T. Vikrit and avikrit. A-V-I-K-A-R-I-T. Avikrit. Vikrit is what? Vikrit. Basically, imbalance of the three dosha called vikrit, and balance of the three dosha called avikrit. So avikrit state. So do you feel that everybody is born avikrit? There is a two personality. Majorly, if we divide into the two personality, the whole world. So there is a group of the people, those who are having the balance of the three dosha, and those who are not having the balance of the three dosha, sick people. What do you think? From sickness to the health, it's come just like that. Sleeping on your couch, watching the television, eating your favorite pizza, pasta, and you are thinking about your three dosha guna balance. No, you require hard work for that. For maintaining it, even if your three dosha is balanced, for maintaining it, you require the hard work for that, isn't it? And it doesn't mean that all the time you're having imbalance of the three dosha. Sometimes it's balanced also. Sometimes it's balanced, but that is that duration we have to increase for putting our effort. So you have to keep this mind. I don't know why people think that 1 month, 2 months. PDF of notes, you get the manual, right? So everything is available, written in the manual here. So you just read about it, and the video is recorded. You can watch later on also. Okay. And I'll show you the one book also, which I'm using for the reference. Ashtanga Hridayam PDF is available. I'll share with you. So understand one thing, that Vata, Pitta and Kapha, to bring into the balance form, it's not like 1 month or 2 months or 3 months you doing the practice of the yoga or following the rituals of the Ayurveda, you would be fit, healthy forever. I don't know why people imagining these things. This kind of, they believe that 1 month, 2 months, they're going to practice and they would be fit forever. This thing not implemented on the modern or allopathic therapy, right? Lifetime they are taking the diabetic pills. Lifetime they are taking the thyroid pills. There's no permanent cure for those things. Lifetime. But they believe yoga will give you, after just practicing 1 month, they will be having, all the problem would be sorted out. Yes, problem would be sorted out. But this thing you have to maintain forever to prevent it. So three dosha, to bringing the balance into the three dosha, you have to maintain, it's a lifelong procedure. It's cannot like, whatever I'm going to tell you, it's not like 1 month, 2 months, you're going to practice it and then you're going to forget about it. You have to follow throughout your life. This is the only way. To keep yourself fit, healthy, and to prevent the disease. So tomorrow we're going to understand that how this three dosha is prevalent in the outside environment, how your age, okay, your season, the climate, day and nights are having the three dosha, and how those things is affecting on us. Tomorrow we're going to talk about it. Till here, any doubts, any difficulty, any question you want to ask?
Ma'am, you just said that whatever we are doing, it's there in the PDF manual, which was given to us by the institute. But this yoga therapy and yoga Ayurveda topic is not there. Rest, everything is there.
Okay. Rest, everything. So I'll show you the book. Most of the thing is not available in the book because I'm sharing through my understanding, and okay, which I learned from the guru. So everything is not available, but I'll show you the one book for the topic. Okay. So okay, you get an idea about it, which topic we are covering and which not. We are not covering whole book, but few things which is very much important to understanding and to providing the treatment, that we would not discuss about.
Because I try my best to write everything, but sometimes you miss out something. So I always think, you know, I'll read later. But this topic is not there in that PDF, which is given to us by Malinists.
So 200 you get, or 300?
Yes, 200.
It is in the 300.
Okay.
Okay, so you get the online students get the opportunity to get this extra class, but it is basically the 300 part. Okay. So let me ask that they are providing the 300 to the 200 online students. Okay. If not, I'll share to the book. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
So let's end the class with the one time om and Shanti Shanti. Come into the sitting posture. Keep your back, neck straight, aligned. Gently close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale for the om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Feel the warmness. Join your both palms, wrap your palms. Place on your eyes. Very slowly while blinking, looking at your palm, gently open up your eyes with a great smile. Bless you guys. Meet you at meditation class. Bye-bye. Take care.